This is my ball python, who hasn't eaten in over a month. I just got her to take a rat. She decided to pull it under her water bowl, so she is officially submerged, eating this rat. I don't think the whole video is going to be her eating, because it takes her a good amount of time. You know, she's about 3 feet long, and she eats a good size rat. But I'll do my best for you. I don't think I can get a clear shot. She's gonna have to readjust eventually, because there's no way she can get the rat to curl down her body like that. She's gonna have to straighten out. That is her neck. Right above that tan, kind of looks like a T in the video. That's the top of her head. See her mouth and her eyes? There you go. She's moving everything in her cage. The pole. That position's still not gonna work. She's gonna move again. She's squeezing that thing pretty hard. It's looks like it's gonna explode. I really hope it doesn't. So that means I need to clean blood and guts up out of this water bowl. She's having a hard time getting the arm in, which is weird because she took it the right way. So you see the arm sticking out. I've never seen her curl this much around her prey. She's almost got it. She's gotta bend the arm back or break it back. Either way. I wonder if I turn this light on, how's it look for you guys? You can see? No. Mouth is so big. Her neck is usually not even close to that. I'm going to try to zoom in. She eats something big enough to stretch all the scales on her neck so you can actually see the skin in between. See it right there? All that pink in between? I mean, everything's pink in the video, but see the separation of the scales? They're supposed to be together. And once she gets that all the way down, they'll go back together. That's all her neck stretched out. There goes the arm. It looks like I'm going to have to make a part two, because this has been over 10 minutes.